Ever since I started lifting years ago, the deadlift has always been one of my favorite lifts. There's just something about the display of strength and technical proficiency that picking something extremely heavy off the ground requires. Over the years, I've gone back and forth between sumo and conventional deadlifts to see which one I can lift more in. I've worked with coaches who have meticulously critiqued and drilled my form, and I've taken countless videos so I can dissect the minutiae and improve this movement. I believe that you'll be able to get the most out of your deadlift by finding a setup that matches your body's levers and by following smart programming. My deadlift meet PR is 455 pounds, and now I'm knocking on the door of that landmark 500 pound deadlift. And with that being said, I'm always looking for ways to increase my deadlift. Enter Ed Coan. Ed Coan, considered by many to be the greatest powerlifter of all time, set 71 world records, including a 901-pound deadlift in the 220-pound weight class, and he was the first lightest person to total over 2,400 pounds. That's pretty impressive. Ed made this deadlift program for Mark Phillippe. Mark is a powerlifting world champion, 7 times world strongest man, and former collegiate strength coach.
Here you can see him deadlifting a van for around 10 reps.
Mark was able to add 35 pounds to his deadlift at the end of the 10 weeks. And I do think it's important to note that the reason why I chose this program is because I haven't focused on adding strength to my deadlift in a while. And I feel like I'm definitely due at this point. I do plan on competing in powerlifting in December, so my overarching scheme is to focus on deadlift for the rest of these 10 weeks. I'll run a squat specific cycle, and then I'll do a bench specific cycle while maintaining all of those other lifts and just putting, I guess, a priority on one of those lifts. And my hope is with this approach, I'll be able to hit new PRs during my meet in December. So let's take a deep dive into the rep schemes and progressions that this program has. To me, this program is very linear and very classic in that sense. You start out at 75% and then you do a set of two.
Meanwhile,
and
with
that, you're focusing on at 60%
pure strength in between
of lifting heavy weights and also the explosiveness that can be practiced while lifting submaximal loads. You'll see both the strength and speed work increases by 5% every week from weeks 1 to 4. And you
However,
know that from
once
weeks
again,
5
very
to
10, classic,
there's some other training variables thrown in there that I think makes this program really excel. Take week 4 for example. In this week, you are hitting a set at 90% of your one rep max. Pretty heavy and therefore pretty costly in terms of recovery. But on week 5, it kicks the intensity or the loading back to 80%. Whereas
I think that
on the other side, with
how
the
speed
this program
squats,
manages
your volume,
intensity and volume really separates it. Because if you try to just continuously linearly push intensity and volume, you could eventually lead to peaking too soon, or you could even be risking injury. And I think it's also important to stress that this is a 10-week program. So many times I'll see newer lifters going into the gym and they'll test their max, and maybe they'll train for 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and then they'll test the max again because for some reason they think that a large amount of adaptations have occurred in that short time period. But what I would say is wait longer. Be patient, train smart, and I think that's a much more effective and sustainable way to train as well. So let's actually get into my training footage and how I'm implementing this in real life. I chose to train my sumo deadlift for this round of the Ed Coan training program. I think 440 with a deadlift bar was a safe bet. So with the deadlift bar in week 1 of this program, I hit 330 for my heavy set of 2. And then my 8 sets of 3 were 265. I ran into some technical difficulties with the camera that I've been using. I've recently got this camera and I had it on the wrong focus setting. So I really apologize for that blurry clip you just saw. But as you can see, 330 without a belt, it moved like butter. And then 265, of course, was light work as well. Unfortunately, I didn't get any footage of my speed work because the gym I was at was very, very packed. And with COVID, I kind of felt a little bit uneasy and I wanted to get in and get out as quick as I could. Regardless though, I was happy with the way 330 moved on that deadlift bar. I've actually joined a new gym since starting this program and I find their bars to be very different. And if you're an experienced deadlifter, you'll get what I mean when a bar really makes a big difference. So a deadlift bar actually has more flex in it, which means you can pull the slack out of the bar and use your own body weight to counterbalance the movement. And it's almost essentially like taking pounds off of that bar when you effectively pull the slack out. The thing is, deadlift bars are about 27 to 28 millimeters in diameter. And the bar that I was currently using is more like 30 to 31 millimeters if I were to guess. It definitely doesn't have a good knurl on it and it's shorter. So obviously less flex means I'm not gonna be able to lift as much weight compared to that deadlift bar. So to be realistic, I decreased my one rep max to 420 as I estimated that this would be reasonable for this bar. However, with that being said, I still feel like 335, which is 80% of that one rep max, moved very well. Here's two different angles, one shot with my phone, one shot with my camera. And then of course, 275 on the speed work was cake as well. And it was very beneficial to get multiple angles on this footage because I feel like, as I was discussing earlier, I could do a better job of overall bracing and pulling the slack out of that barbell. Just something I'm gonna work on in the future to make sure my deadlift progression works as well as it can. Another thing that I'll note is, with this footage, I was realizing I did touch and go reps, whereas from now on, I'm gonna switch it up and do reset reps. You can see that with these touch and go reps, I was just kind of like, lifting, setting the bar down, lifting, setting the bar down, lifting. But with reset reps, that's more specific and realistic to how a meet would actually go, because you want to completely reset, get another great brace, and set up to the bar as you would if you were hitting a single every time. So basically, I'm just going to give myself another 3 or 4 more seconds in between each lift to reset, get a brace, and go from there. Here's a clip of what that will actually look like, and that's what I'm going to be doing from here on out. So guys, on the day that I'm uploading this, I'll be hitting 355 for my set of two, followed by 6 sets of 3 at 295. So load is starting to get to a more challenging level. I might belt up, we'll see how that weight feels and moves. But I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how my progression goes with this series. It's gonna be a weekly thing where you can check out how my deadlift is going. And overall, the goal for this series is to show you what I'm doing with my deadlift, so hopefully you can take those things and improve your deadlift as well. Overall though guys, I'm really loving this Ed Coan deadlift program, so run it yourself. You can find it by Googling the Ed Coan deadlift program. The clip that I used earlier is from lift.net. I think they also have a very good breakdown of this program and some of the things that it has going for it. But I just wanna say guys, thank you all so much for checking this video out. If you feel like you learned something, I would really appreciate it if you hit me with a like. Share this with your lifting friends. Subscribe for more videos just like this on a weekly basis. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Have a great day.